Hey, what's up guys? So today I am making some beans and I let my beans soak last night. I got a new crock pot. You guys remember I bought a new crock pot. Anyway, so I let my beans soak overnight last night and they are already in the crock. I'm gonna do some red beans. Right here I have some salt pork just like before. Skillet is already hot. I had to run out last night to the market because when I decided I was gonna make beans, I was like, oh my god, I don't have a skillet. So I ran out and got a skillet. So the salt pork is in there. In this bowl right here, I've got garlic, fresh garlic. I got some red and green pepper along with some onion. And I'm going to do a little twist today on my beans. I'm going to add some steak to them. And I'm also going to add you guys will see what it is as we go along. So this is the first part. What I'm going to do right now is let this salt pork get brown on both sides, and then I will use the same skillet that I did the salt pork in to saute the onions, peppers, and garlic. And then I'm gonna chop up the salt pork. I'll show you guys as I go along. So this is part one, guys. See you in a minute. Bye. Hey guys, what's up? Let me just tell you that this smells so incredibly yummy. And guess what? I think that's the UPS truck right there. I think I have a delivery coming today from my friend April, and I wonder what it is. Anyway, guys, this is the salt pork right here, and I'm gonna be taking this out and sitting it over here. Be back in a second. Okay, guys, what's up? I'm back. These are, this is the first part of the onions and garlic and bell pepper mixture, and all I did was I put it in the same pan, drained a little bit of the oil out because I have two batches, and so this is what it looks like right now. And what I do is I just try to let these get like a nice little saute. Sorry if I'm moving the camera, I'm not looking through the lens. Anyway, I try to let these get like a nice little saute till they're kind of tender. And that's it. But what I want to show you is this right here. Dun, 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 dun. So, my guy from UPS just delivered my box. And I have an idea of what it is. Actually, I already know what it is. But I'm going to surprise you guys. This is from my friend April, who I met through YouTube. She's also on my blog. My blog network. I'm hoping to see a blog from her really, really soon. Powerful, powerful sister. With a great YouTube channel. You guys check her out. I'll put a descript, a link for her YouTube channel in the descript of this video. All right, guys, I'll be back in a second. Bye. All right, guys, so this is what was in the box. I got an everyday nonstick three-piece Kalfin set. A saucepan. Dun, 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 dun. And a a saute pan and a saucepan. A pot and a skillet is what I got y'all. Thank you, April!
Look, I can see myself in the lid.
Okay, so this is perfect. I'll be breaking this baby in the next video. April, thank you so much. You rock, baby. I love you. Bye bye. Okay guys, what's up? We are back. So right here, I'm not sure you guys are going to be able to hear me all that well. Okay, I hope you guys can hear me now. So right here, I have my salt pork all cut up. Mom used to just pull it apart once it cooled down. I cut mine apart, cut mine in pieces. That's my dishwater right there. So it's gonna go back into the skillet for a minute. Look, Rachel. I mean, April. I got these the other night at Bed Bath & Beyond. They were on sale. 3 spoons for $2.49. And this is your skillet, Mama. Look at that. Oh, you probably can't see it. Oh, there it is. There it is. Whew, don't want to burn my lens. Okay, so we're just going to dump all this back into there. And this is just going to saute for just a second. All I'm basically doing is letting all the yummy, yummy goodness mix in. I did add a little bit of seasoning to this. You really don't have to add a lot of seasoning because of the salt pork. But I did add some Zatarain's Creole seasoning. My girl Tina picked that up for me at the 99-cent store. 99-cent only stores. Nothing over 99 cents. Ever.
Ever, ever, devil.
Okay, so this is doing pretty good. I'm going to let this go for about 2 to 3 minutes. Actually, just long enough for me to pull this out and show you guys what I got in here. See my refrigerator? Yeah, I got a box of bag in a box. That's a box that gets you fucked up. Anyway, right here what I have is a beef shank center cut. Now, I got this at a Mexican market. Sometimes, actually all the time, when you're buying meats, places like Vons and Ralph's and stuff, they don't have a butcher. There are places like Stater Brothers where they have a butcher, but Stater Brothers are far and few in between. But if you go to a Mexican market like Vallarta or even the little Mexican corner markets where they have a butcher on site, they can cut your meat the way you want it. And so what I got was a beef shank center cut. I got 2 fat pieces in here for $4.64. Let me show you what they look like real quick. See? That looks good, doesn't it? Nice, baby. So that's going to be going into the beans as well. I'll be back in a second. Alright guys, we are back. The shank has already been added to the mixture there. Let me just give this a stir to show you guys. This smells so good. See how nice and thick that is? And I didn't season the shank. And the reason I didn't season the shank is because there is enough seasoning in this mixture here for the shank and for the beans. So turn off the flame, and that is gonna go right into the crock with the beans. See all that yumminess in the skillet? I'm gonna scrape that out and put that into there. Look at that. This is gonna be so good. You guys just don't know. Now we're not finished yet. We are not finished yet. We still have 2 more secret ingredients to add in. I will be back in a second. All right, y'all, so this is the wrap. Part of the secret is I added 2 cans of Italian stewed tomatoes. And the last secret ingredient is chorizo. Beef flavor chorizo. So that's gonna go into that, that's gonna go into there, and then this is gonna cook for about 3 to 4 hours. That's it, guys. That's the beans that I make. This is my twist on beans. Actually, I just made this up as I went along. This looks really, really good, and the chorizo is just gonna just set this off, baby. Peace and blessings, everybody. April, thanks so much for the cook set. I love you. Thanks for watching, guys. If you're not reading my blog, please check out my blog. Follow me on Facebook and on Twitter. Peace and blessings, everybody. Bye-bye.